हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ रोहिणी अखिल, श्री रेमिनाथ जैन विद्यालय संगवड़। इन अवर सेकेंड चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन अ न्यू टॉपिक, सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इन ह्यूमन। एंड अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इन बर्ड्स। एट द फर्स्ट टॉपिक, सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इन ह्यूमन। ह्यूमन बीइंग शोज टोटल 46 क्रोमोसोम इन हिज जीनोम। देर आर 46 क्रोमोसोम। आउट ऑफ दैट 46 क्रोमोसोम, 44 आर ऑटोसोम्स। 44 आर ऑटोसोम्स एंड दीज टू आर सेक्स क्रोमोसोम। In male, 44 autosome and one is X and another is Y chromosome, means 44, 45 and total 46. There are total 46 chromosome in human genome. This is the genotype of male. Then in female, what is the genotype? Same as in male, 44 autosomes and these two are sex chromosome. But what is the difference in male and female? In male, sex chromosomes are of X and Y. Here, in female, XX means female have two X chromosome. Female does not have Y chromosome. Means Y chromosome is present only in male. And in female, there is XX chromosome. In female, 44, 45, 46. Means female also have 46 chromosome in her genome. In genome, 46, 46 chromosome are there in male and in female. Difference is of only Y. Y is present in male and Y is replaced by X chromosome in female. Means Y chromosome is responsible for male. And hence Y chromosome is responsible for male. While here X chromosome is responsible for female. In short. Okay. Then. Next. What is this? X, Y. Okay. In gamete formation or during the gamete formation, what happened? These 44 gets segregated into 2. 22, 22. During gamete formation, 44 autosome get divided into 22, 22 pairs. Okay. Then these X and Y, they also get divided. Means first pair is with 22X and second is with 22Y. Okay? Then what about the female? In female, same as it is, 22, 22. 44 get divided into 2. And here one is X and another is also X. Means if these are parents and these are gametes, okay, these are genotypes. Okay, parents will be male, female. Genotype are 44XY in male and 44XX in female. Then gametes are separated. Four types of gametes will be obtained. Then we have to determine how the son will be produced and how the daughter will be produced. How the sex of baby will be determined by their genotype. Okay. We have taken the first fertilization. Here, what is the result? What is the progeny? 22, 22 becomes 44. Then here X and X. This genotype belongs from either it show double X means it is a female. Okay, we may recall her as a daughter. Okay, as being these are parents, then the offspring is daughter. Then next, what is the result? 22 becomes 44, and then X comes first and then Y. What is he as is corresponding Y? He is a man. Then we also call him as a son, as these are parents. He is a son. Okay, means how the daughter and son will produce? Daughter is produced by the crossing of X chromosome from male and X chromosome from female. Then they produce as daughter. Then how the son or male child will be produced? Y 22 autosome and Y chromosome from male and X chromosome from female. Then they produce the male child. Okay, then question. What is the question? Who is responsible for producing male child? Okay, what is the question? Who is responsible for producing male child? Okay, what is the question? Okay, what is the question? Who is responsible for producing the male child? Who is responsible for producing male child? Male character is determined by Y chromosome. Okay, it is determined by Y chromosome. Then where is Y chromosome? Okay, here is Y chromosome. Then Y chromosome comes from male. Okay, means male is responsible from parents. Okay, from parents male is responsible for producing male child. Okay, in our community, what is the misconception? Who is blamed? Female or mother got some, she suffers from certain blaming, as she does not able to produce the male child. But today you have noticed here in sex determination of human being, who is responsible for producing male child? Father is responsible for producing his son and daughter. From male, if X chromosome is there, he produces a daughter. And if from male Y chromosome is there, he produces son. Okay. But in female, there is both are XX. Means both are responsible for femaleness. Only Y is responsible for producing the male child or male son. From today's topic, we have learned that father is responsible for producing the male child or his son and not the mother. Okay. In next topic or in previous topic, we have discussed the sex determination in human being. The next topic is sex determination in birds. In case of birds, the sex determination is of ZWZZ type. Okay? In an MCQ or in very short answer question, the question may be asked, what is the type of sex determination in birds? What is the type? It is ZWZZ type. In human being, it is XXXY type. Okay. In human, it is XXXY type. And in bird, it is ZWZZ type. Okay. One trick is there. Small trick is there. How to remember this. We have to note the female at first time and male on latter. Here in birds, this is female. In human, this is also female. Okay? And male comes later on. Female at first time and male on latter. Okay? Then the next, how we determine the sex of birds. Either it is female or either it is male. Then if we take the male and a female as a parents, okay, if these are the parents, the male having the genotype ZZ and the female having ZW, then male produces two gametes ZZ and female produces ZW. Here we have take only sex chromosome. Along with this, we have also take the autosomes also, like that. Male is diploid in nature, means we have take here 2N and in female 2N. Then after gametogenesis, what are these? These are gametes. After gametogenesis, what happen? They becomes haploid, means a single N is there, single N is there, single N, single N, means they becomes haploid. Okay, all the gametes becomes haploid during gametogenesis. Then during the process of fertilization, what happen? Again these 2N, they again becomes diploid. Along with these 2N, ZZ, one Z gamete from male and another Z gamete from the female, they gets unite or they gets fertilized to form the male bird. What is the genotype for male bird? The genotype for male bird are ZZ and this is called as male bird. Then in next, single N from male and one more single N from female, they becomes 2N, that is she become diploid. Then a single Z from male and W from the female, they gets fertilized and they form ZW and the offspring will be female bird. What are the genotype for the female bird? It is diploid in nature and she having the ZW. If W chromosome is there, then she is a female bird. And if both are ZZ, then they become a male bird. What is the difference between the human chromosome and bird chromosome? In human being, male and female. Okay? Here, human and here, birds. Okay? In male, human male, it is heterogametic. Means it having X and Y, that is it is heterogametic, means having two separate gametes or two different gametes. And female is with XX, means she is homogametic, both chromosomes are same. In case of birds, what is the condition? Male is ZZ, means it having the same gamete, means it is homogametic. But in female bird, what is the condition? ZW, means it having two different chromosomes, means it is heterogametic. Okay? Means in human, male is heterogametic, while in birds, female is heterogametic. In birds, male is homogametic, and in human, female is homogamic. Note out this. In our next topic, sex determination in honeybee. In previous, we have discussed the sex determination in human, sex determination in birds. What is the type of sex determination in human? It is XX, XY type. In birds, it is ZZ, ZW type. But in honeybee, the sex determination type is haplodiploid type. Haplodiploid type. Haploid means a single set of chromosome and diploid means two sets of chromosomes. Okay. If the progeny or if the offspring with haploid set of chromosome and if the offspring is on the diploid set of chromosome. Okay. If it becomes haploid, if any progeny or offspring with haploid set of chromosome, then it is considered as male. And if an offspring with diploid set of chromosome, then it is considered as a female. Means how the male honeybee will produce? If the offspring with haploid set of chromosome. And if any individual or offspring possess the diploid set of chromosome, then there will be a female honeybee. Let us see the example.